can see that the church of God is sleeping. And because the church is sleeping, God is saying to the church, wake up. Somebody say, wake up.
Wake up.
Somebody say, wake up.
Wake up.
That is why I'm speaking on the subject, the spirit of the last days. The spirit of the last days. This is the last days. This is the end time. And it will take a man, a woman, who have the ears of the spirit to understand that the season that we are in is a perilous time. And the period we are in is a perilous time. Open to the book of 1 Timothy chapter 4. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 1. Who is there? Who is there? Yes.
The Spirit says clearly that some people will abandon the faith.
Come again.
The Spirit says clearly that some people.
The Spirit says what?
Clearly.
Again?
Clearly.
Clearly. Yes?
That some people will abandon the faith.
That some people will abandon the faith.
In later times.
In later times.
They will obey lying spirits.
They will obey lying spirits.
And follow the teaching of the demons.
And follow the teaching of demons. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the later times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils or demons. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is the last days. When we look at the agenda of God from the scripture, we have seven dispensations. We have dispensation of innocence, dispensation of conscience, dispensation of human government, we have dispensation of promise, we have dispensation of law, we have dispensation of grace, and we have dispensation of divine government. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The dispensation we are now is the dispensation of grace. Already the world has gone through five dispensations. And this is the sixth dispensation. And six is the number of man. And after this dispensation, when we end this dispensation is a rapture. Is somebody with me here today? When we end this dispensation is rapture. But before the rapture will sound, some things are bound to happen. Certain things are expected to manifest on earth. And what are those things? That is what we just read. That in the later times, in the last days, perilous times shall come, troublous times shall come, and men will give heed to seducing spirits, which will make many to fall away. How many Christians today got born again 10 years ago and they are still born again today? How many people got born again 10 years ago and today they are still born again? How many people got born again 5 years ago and today they are still born again? The reason is because this is the last days. And because this is the last days, the devil, demons are out to make sure that believers, they drop their sword and they drop their Bible. For your information, devil has vowed that he will make sure that every minister of God, that he will make sure their children become disgrace to their ministries. So if a church worker here, can I see your hand up? You are a worker in your church. Raise up your hand. I mean, you are waiting for another person to raise that before you raise your own. Praise the Lord. So, the devil has determined to make sure that the children of those who are serving God will become a disgrace to their ministry. I pray that will not be my portion.
Amen.
What about you? If that will not be your portion, let your amen be louder.
Amen.
Two spirits will dominate the last days. Two kinds of spirit. Number one is the spirit of lukewarmness, where you will see Christians who were on fire for God before, their fire will quench. They will be struggling to go to church, struggling to serve God, struggling to walk with God. They will prefer to work for God than to walk with God. It is different to work for God. It is a different thing to walk with God. If you are busy working for God and you are not working with God, it is dangerous. A person working for God and not working with God is the type that we see that will come early to church, that will sweep church, come to ministry, intercede, pray, do everything well, but his character is zero. He always grows angry. He can slap anybody who insults him. He can fight anywhere. He will tell you, my Christianity does not reach this place. Conductor will shout on him. He will shout back at the conductor. Say, if you talk to me again, I will show you who I am. Even though he wears suit and tie on Sunday, he will tell conductor, I will drop my Bible here. I will pull up my suit. I will put it aside. I will deal with you mercilessly. And after, I will carry my Bible again and I will serve God. Somebody told me, he said, Pastor Shago, I told that pastor that if he talk too much, I will slap him, I will beat him, and if you make sound in that place, I will make heaven, I will reach heaven before him. It means I will be the first man to fly. I will get to heaven before him. The spirit of the last days will make people feel that God is a joker. Will make people feel that God does not know what he's doing. The spirit of lukewarmness, people will become such, serving God will be a stress. Evangelism will be a stress. Why are they stressing us? Why are they disturbing me? This was the same person before, that before you make sure evangel, he will tell me the word of God. Lukewarmness. A person who loves using his money for God before, but now he will say those pastors are liars, they are thieves. I better use my money to feed myself. A man who does not drink beer before, but is now drinking beer. He was once a child of God, now he's a child of beer. A lady before who was serving God very innocent, but now at a secret commit fornication and still come and carry Bible and sing. A man, a brother who was once serving God before, but now the spiritual fire is zero. Why? Because the spirit of lukewarmness has become the order of the day. But God is saying, my church is sleeping. The other spirit that will dominate the end time is the Holy Ghost. Somebody say Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Somebody say Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
And the Holy Ghost is going to be working with those decisive. Those few who has made up their mind. Those few who have decided that come rain, come sun, I will serve God till I die. Those few who are holding on to their salvation. Those are people that the Holy Ghost will walk upon. And they are the believers who will be on fire. No.